Let's move on and talk about how a country's central bank goes about conducting monetary policy. There are three tools that a central bank has at its disposal. There is a catch, though, and that catch is that the central bank must choose one tool. It cannot manipulate all three at the same time. The monetary base is essentially the quantity of money flowing within the economy. It can also manipulate the exchange rate. But the most interesting tool of choice, and the one which I will be emphasizing, is something known as the overnight loans rate. The overnight loans rate is the interest rate on overnight loans that banks make to each other. At the end of the day, when all transactions have been made, banks need to actually transfer money into each other's reserve accounts according to how much their customers have spent. If I buy something from Metro, my local grocery store, using my debit card, my bank must transfer money into Metro's bank account. But say Metro has its banking accounts at a different bank. In this case, my bank must send money to the other bank. Sometimes banks do not have enough reserves to send money over to other banks. In this case, they take out what is known as an overnight loan. An overnight loan is exactly what it sounds like. It's a loan that is paid back by the next day. Let's see how the central bank manipulates this thing known as the overnight loans rate. The first thing I want to mention about this graph is that it shows the relationship between the overnight loans rate and the bank reserves that are held at the central bank. For the purposes of this graph, we're going to assume that the zero axis is a bit further to the right than on other graphs. We'll assume that at the gray line, there are zero reserves at the central bank. Let's say that the central bank puts its target overnight loans rate at some arbitrary number. It now needs to manipulate the market in order to achieve this target. The central bank uses two other interest rates to do this. The bank rate is the rate that the central bank charges big banks on overnight loans. This is always set at 0.25% above the target overnight rate. The bank rate acts like a maximum overnight loans rate because if a bank wants to borrow at a lower rate from another bank, it will not borrow from the central bank. In addition, no bank would charge higher than the bank rate because no bank would borrow the money from it if the central bank's rate is less. In essence, the bank rate acts as a cap or a maximum that the overnight loans rate can be at any given time. The settlement balances rate is the interest rate that a central bank pays on reserves held in its accounts, and it is set at 0.25% below the target overnight loans rate. It acts as an absolute maximum value that the overnight loans rate could take. Banks wouldn't make overnight loans to other banks unless they earned a higher interest rate than what the central bank is offering as a rate of return in its reserves. No bank would charge a lower interest rate than the settlement balances rate because it could simply earn more interest if it were to leave its money in its reserve account at the central bank. This entire range, or the area between the bank rate and the settlement balances rate, is known as the operating band. The overnight loans rate will be somewhere in between this operating band because of the effects I mentioned that the bank rate and the settlement balances rate have. This weird-looking curve is the shape that the demand for reserves curve takes. The line does not go over the bank rate or below the settlement balances rate because no bank would borrow money above the bank rate and no bank would lend money below the settlement balances rate. This is where the zero axis becomes important. If the quantity demanded for reserves is below zero, it is shown graphically as to the left of the zero line. In practical terms, this would mean that the entire banking system is borrowing from the central bank. The central bank's open market operations will determine the actual amount of reserves at the central bank. Just like with any other economic model, there is an equilibrium. The equilibrium occurs where the quantity of reserves at the central bank equals the reserves demanded. This determines the overnight loans rate. The central bank can alter the overnight loans rate by manipulating the amount of reserves. If the overnight rate is higher than the target rate, we arrive at a situation where the reserves in the central bank are lower than they need to be in order to achieve the target rate. The central bank conducts open market operations by buying government securities from banks. The central bank pays commercial banks for these securities by transferring money into their reserves. This in turn increases total reserves and brings the overnight loans rate down. Conversely, if the overnight loans rate is lower than the target rate, the central bank sells to government securities. Commercial banks pay for these securities with their reserves, thus decreasing the amount of their reserves. This raises the overnight loans rate to the target rate.